ask you to please keep in mind all those affected in Texas, and we thank God for the safety and security of our school at St. Hilary's. Loving Father, we praise you for your goodness in making the beauty of this world and for calling us to be your people. We thank you for all the gifts you give to your church, especially the gift of music and art. Bless those who use their gifts to give joy to your people and to lead them in praising you more fully through music. We praise you and thank you for letting artists see the beauty of your creation and to share it with us through the works of art. Bless these musicians who are with us tonight, and let it be a reminder to all who admire it that you, our God and our Father, teach us to reflect your truth and your goodness in our lives each day. So give your honor and glory. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm going to turn it over to our MC for the evening.
Good evening, everybody. As Mrs. Fagan said, this is the return. Okay, we are live streaming. So if you would like to be able to view it afterwards, you can, which might save you some videoing. This is a return to in-person performances after 2 years of being virtual. As we know, 2020 and 2021 had a tremendous effect on the arts overall, theater, music, and it would be false to say that it didn't affect music in schools. Lucky for us, we have a very devoted and determined music teacher, and so we did have virtual arts festivals, but it is not quite the same as being here in person. We have a variety of acts this evening, a variety of instrumentalists and vocalists. We have everything from Beethoven to Taylor Swift. We have violinists, we have French horn, we have students who will play in a mini orchestra, and we have students who will play in rock band. So you're going to hear the whole gamut of music. And as we transition from act to act, I'll just ask for your patience in doing so. And don't worry, I did Google some jokes if we have some extra time, so I can share those with you. I will say on behalf of a parent and a teacher in the school, I do encourage you to look towards the music program as an outlet for your children. Mr. Jew offers summer lessons and lessons in the fall, and many of the students you see here tonight really have flourished under his tutelage. We are going to have 17 acts tonight. A couple of them will play multiple songs, but we do begin with one of the classics, which is our handbell ensemble, and this ensemble represents sixth grade. So, sixth grade, if you'd like to come forward, please, get ready to play your piece. The sixth grade handbell ensemble will be performing a song called Reflection from the movie Mulan. Mr. Jew actually orchestrated and arranged the music for this piece for 12 musicians. So as you count them coming up, you'll notice 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what that means is that we have some brave young ladies who are going to be playing more than their allotted 2 bells. In fact, Alyssa, how many bells are you playing?
Five bells.
So this is quite an achievement for this young group. This is their very first time playing in public. We were not able to have them play at Christmas. We were not able to have them play last year or practice last year. So they've been doing their very best, and I'm sure they're going to do a wonderful job this evening. So this is Mulan, the song called Reflection.
Thank you.
Since that was so good, you're getting your first joke. What is Beethoven's favorite fruit? Banana. Right? Why did the fish make such a good musician? Because he knew his scales. And one more. Which Christmas elf was the best singer? Elvis Presley.
Right, no, please. We'll be here all night if you do that.
Our second of 17 acts is an instrumentalist, and it's Stella Montana. Stella is in seventh grade, and this evening Stella will be performing Ave Maria by Franz Schubert. Now, Stella has been very, very diligent with her music practicing. And one of the things that is obvious with Stella is that she is engaged with her instrument. She is very enthusiastic. She volunteers for masses and for any of the events that we need musicians for. And, you know, Mr. Drew really appreciates that. There's nothing more special than being able to share your talent, and Stella certainly does that. So Stella tonight will be playing Ave Maria by Schubert.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Stella. That was beautiful. Our next performer is our youngest performer this evening. She is in fourth grade, and her name is Julia Brady. Now, in the past, at these festivals, Mr. Jew would have the full school choir sing, or even the glee club sing, and we were unable to do that in the past year because of COVID restrictions. So we're building back up a little bit the program, and hopefully we'll have a full choir next year. So Mr. Jew took the opportunity to be able to showcase some of his younger musicians and singers. And Julia has been practicing a lot. She can sing quite a few beautiful songs very well. And she has chosen to sing Tomorrow from Annie. Julia takes lessons with Mr. Jew, and this is her first performance. Julia. When I was a little girl, I used to ask Santa Claus for a voice like that, and unfortunately he did not hand it over. Our fourth act this evening is another handbell ensemble. This is seventh grade, and this really should have been their second year performing, but it's actually their first year. Mr. Jew informs me that they are very excited, which I would say is a true statement of fact about them as a class in general, and not just about handbells. They're going to be performing the theme from The Office. So as they get set up, one of the things I told Mr. Jew I would do is that I would show you, because you know I'm from Ireland, we play a lot of instruments there, and my family are very musical. I'm the only one that's not, unfortunately, which is why I was banished to America.
But we play a lot of instruments that you can carry around, so we can go to sessions in people's houses. Often after a funeral or wedding, there's music in the home. And the simplest and first one you learn in Ireland as a child is the tin whistle. You learn the recorder here, we learn the tin whistle. It's called a tin whistle because it's tin. And it has 6 holes, I know that, and it's got a D on it, which I can't remember what it means. But really, probably when you're 8, 9 years old, you learn the tin whistle. So we're going to give it one little shot, and then we'll move on. So that's a tin whistle, and there'll be 2 more I'll show you later. And as we're organizing, it's time for another joke. Why is a piano so hard to open? Because the keys are on the inside. What type of music are balloons afraid of? Yeah, pop music. That was easy. What kind of music do bunny rabbits like? Hip-hop. Okay, these are getting stale. What is a skeleton's favorite instrument? Do you know? Think of the word skeleton. What are they made of? Trombone. Very good. What do you call a cow that can play a musical instrument? A musician. And lastly, what is the difference between a fish and a piano? You can't tune a fish. Okay. Okay, so that's it. That's it for the jokes, folks. Now, the song that 7th grader performing is the theme song from The Office. And I know they've been working very hard at it. So take it away, 7th grade. Thank you, 7th grade. That's very good. That's actually a lot harder than it looks. I don't know if some of you have older children will remember at one of the Catholic Schools Week, maybe 4 years ago or 5 years ago, the teachers decided we would do it as our performance. And there was kind of war at some point. It was not easy. There was crying. I was relegated to one bell, I believe, because that's all I could handle. So it's actually a lot harder than it looks. So I'm always impressed when they can pull these things off in such a beautiful way. We now move to another instrumentalist, and this is an 8th grader. It's lovely to have an 8th grader perform at her final music festival. And it's Olivia Forkin, and Olivia plays the flute. Tonight she's performing Le Cinquantaine by Jean-Gabriel Marie. those are all his names, French composer. And La Cinquantaine means the 50th anniversary, and it's a song that's often played at 50th anniversary, golden anniversary celebrations. Olivia also plays in our mini orchestra, so you will see her later in the orchestra. But we welcome Olivia, and we look forward to hearing La Cinquantaine.
Thank you.
Very composed, Olivia, let me tell you. Owen, that was very helpful. Thank you for helping her. That's what they do for each other. We now have a vocalist from seventh grade. Her name is Reagan Gilmore. And Reagan is doing a solo. She didn't originally plan to do a solo. Now she is this evening, so we're looking forward to it. Reagan has chosen a song from the movie Tangled, and it's called When Will My Life Begin? And of course, Tangled is the story of Rapunzel, and Disney did a beautiful job of adding wonderful music to it. So Reagan is going to sing When Will My Life Begin from Tangled. Thank you, Reagan. That was lovely. We move now to the eighth grade handbell ensemble, and they're going to be playing How to Save a Life by The Fray. Now, eighth grade did play in sixth grade before we had a lot of restrictions. But this is their first time playing together in a while. But if memory recalls, they were actually very, very good in sixth grade, so I'm sure we will see the same performance. So I'll take this minute to show you the next Irish instrument I brought. And instead of jamming your whole drum set into the boot or trunk of your car, you would take one of these. This is called a bowron, B-O-D-H-R-A-N, it's Gaelic, there's consonants everywhere. Bowron, okay, it's basically a wooden frame and a crossbar at the back, and then it's covered in goatskin. Dried goatskin. Now this has a Celtic decoration on it, but most of the professionals wouldn't have that. They would just have a plain one. And you have this as your percussion, as your drum in the living room, in the corner, in the pub, wherever the music session is taking place. And you have a stick that I'll show you, and you hold it like a pencil, and then you just create rhythm.
Theoretically.
You would be sitting, so you would sit, and it's very simple. I'll
So you need to be very careful how you use it. But that is actual real goat skin, and that is actually an instrument that we use in my granny's living room in Ireland when we play. And that's often an instrument that the children will start with, or the tin whistle, because it's not the fiddle that Uncle Jerry's playing, it's not the guitar your father's playing, it's something simpler. And you always had to have a song, too. Now, the song may not be as modern or as exciting as the one that our 8th grade handbells are going to play, but I'm sure it will be equally in tune. And it is called How to Save a Life by The Fray. Thank you very much, 8th grade. I realize it's kind of disconcerting when you're sitting, your face is right there, and this 5-pound bell's being swung in your face. This is why they had a moment of fear, but they held on to them. That was very good. Thank you very much. We move now back to our instrumentalist, and this young man plays the French horn, and his name is Gavin Budney. He's also in 8th grade. Gavin is the first and only French horn that Mr. Dew has ever had at St. Hilary's School. Gavin will be performing a Beethoven classic, Für Elise, which means for Elise in German, which is interesting because the love of his life was Therese, or Therese, but this is written as for Elise, so many people believe that it was just written down incorrectly or copied incorrectly. The song is very famous for being played on the piano, but Gavin will play it on the French horn. Gavin has received a music scholarship to Archbishop Wood, and that's where he's going to attend. Now, he did have a bit of a challenge today with the instrument and had to go to the music hospital and the music store, and I'm glad to see that it's back in action. So we welcome Gavin playing Für Elise by Beethoven.
And I don't know if you could see the instrument, but it's really a very beautiful instrument. The shape, and of course Gavin has it in beautiful condition. Not an easy instrument to play, and a difficult song, and you did a lovely job. Thanks, Gavin. The next performance is by somebody that I know pretty well, and her name is Julia Burdick, and she's in eighth grade. Now, Julia has chosen a song called Oceans by Hillsong United. Hillsong United is a worship group that's based in Australia, and because she's such a good sport, she's agreed to sing it with an Australian accent to give us the real effect. So thanks for that, Jules. But the song is basically a worship song, and it's become quite popular around the world. So this is Oceans by Hillsong United.
Thank you.
Thank you, Julia. That was lovely. That's one of the things I most enjoy about Mr. Jew being at school and the liturgies and masses we have, is that I hear music and hymns and faith music and worship music that I didn't hear as a child. And I think it's beautiful. And oftentimes when we have the First Friday masses, I'm crying because the music is so beautiful. The children singing it is so lovely. So that's another beautiful gift that Mr. Jew has given us, is this knowledge of a wide variety of music to enrich our liturgies. Now, our next performance is actually a young lady who has been playing the piano for quite some time. Her name is Alyssa Trin, and she's in seventh grade. And her song this evening is called Paper Hearts by Tori Kelly. And Alyssa, is this your first time performing at the Arts Festival? You did it virtually. This is in person. Well, take it away, Alyssa. We look forward to hearing Paper Hearts by Tori Kelly. Thank you, Alyssa. That was beautiful. Can I please have St. Hilary School B Rock Band come on up? So this is the first of our two rock bands that will be performing this evening. This rock band consists of the younger rock and rollers. There was a lot of interest in rock band. And as Mr. Jew said, you can't have five drummers and, you know, six guitarists. So he set up a second rock band. So these students are in fourth and fifth grade. And they're going to be playing two selections tonight. The first selection is called The Scientist by Coldplay. And as you'll notice, they move around easily. So Kyler Jew and Gabe Palomaro will be actually switching instruments for the second song. Starting out in a rock band, if you watch the movies, you know it's a challenge. We've all watched movies with rock bands starting out, and that was no different for these guys, because a lot of the time they were used to playing by themselves. So once the bumps and bruises were ironed out, they were able to get together and really make some nice music. So the first selection they will play is The Scientist by Coldplay. Thank you.
That was fantastic. That makes me want to go back to fourth grade and join a band in a garage or something and do something with my life. learn how to play an instrument. The second song that they're going to be playing is State of Grace by Pennsylvania native Taylor Swift. So the song is called State of Grace, and you'll notice that our drummer and our keyboardist have switched places.
I never, never know you by.
We move now back to a duet. And the duet is Paige Coyle and Juliet Levy, and they're in seventh grade. They're going to be singing a song from The Greatest Showman, and the song is called Never Enough. They're fresh off a very beautiful performance at Living Stations, as are the other seventh grade singers. Living Stations this year was back to being something that we could all experience, not on a screen, and we didn't have a choir the last 2 years, a full choir, so I think Mr. Jew was hopeful that people would have remembered some of the singing lessons and things, and he was not disappointed. And these are two of the beautiful voices that sang for Living Stations. The song is called Never Enough, and the movie is called The Greatest Showman. And this is Paige Coyle and Juliet Levy.
A dream in me, getting louder now. Can you hear it echoing? Take my hand, will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, all the shine of thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough. Never be enough. Never the gold are still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll never be enough. Never be enough for me.
Thank you. Thank you, girls. That was lovely. We turn now to Italy and to the famous operatic tenor Andrea Bocelli. And Bocelli has three children, and wouldn't you know it, one of his sons inherited that beautiful, beautiful voice, Matteo. So the song that is being sung is called Fall on Me. and it's appropriately sung by Sienna Doherty. Sienna is in eighth grade here and has graced us with her beautiful voice in many liturgies, and it never fails to impress. And it's all the more poignant since Nono and Nona are here representing Italy. So Sienna will actually sing the second verse in Italian. So I look forward to hearing that. Take it away, Sienna. This is Fall on Me by Andrea and Matteo Bocelli.
Abbracciami, follow me.
That was beautiful. Thank you very much. Just to draw your attention, on the back of your sheet, if you haven't noticed already, is a list of all the performers who are in handbells, rock band, and mini orchestra. It is time to turn to our mini orchestra right now. So we have a violin, two violins, one, two, three flutes, and the French horn. One of the casualties of not having the live arts festival the last couple 2 years is that the younger children don't get to see the older children perform. And they don't say, oh, I want to do that, Dad, or I want to try that, Mom. There was a young man here, it's actually Julia Brady's older brother, James Brady, and I remember he played the trumpet at an arts festival here, and it was phenomenal, and he went on to play in high school. And after, Mr. Jew had 3 or 4 requests from younger kids to try trumpet lessons. And I think that's what we kind of missed. So looking forward to getting that opportunity again for younger children to see the older children and think, hey, that's great, I want to try that too. It is termed a mini orchestra. It has been bigger in the past, and hopefully we'll go back to that in the future, God willing. So the mini orchestra actually has 4 short selections. We begin with the first one, so there's not the full arrangement, but the 4 short selections. The first one is Water Music by Handel. Second selection is Over the Rainbow from The Wizard of Oz.
And changing gears, we move forward to the theme music for Super Mario Brothers. And their final selection is the theme music for Star Wars. Our next performer is another flautist, and her name is Allison Lawn, and she is an eighth grader. Allison is another student in eighth grade who received music scholarships to Nazareth Academy and Archbishop Wood, and she'll be attending Archbishop Wood this fall. Allison's going to play two pieces for us. The first is Nocturne by Chopin. Thank you. Allie's second selection is Salut d'Amour, which means greeting of love, and it's by Sir Edward Elgar. That was lovely, Ali. Thank you very much. We now move to another seventh grade student who will be playing the guitar and singing for us. And it's Connor Wisniewski. And Connor's choice is a song called Welcome to My World by Simple Plan. So Connor will be playing the guitar and singing, which is befuddles me because I can't chew gum and walk at the same time. So it's quite a privilege to see a young person with this kind of skill.
Do you ever feel like breaking down? Do you ever feel out of place? Like somehow you just don't belong and no one understands you? Do you ever want to run away? Do you lock yourself in your room with the radio on turned up so loud that no one hears you screaming? No, you don't know what it's like when nothing feels alright. You don't know what it's like to be like me, to be hurt, to feel lost, to be left out in the dark, to be kicked when you're down, feel like you've been pushed around, to be on the edge of breaking down when no one's there to save you. No, you don't know what it's like. Welcome to my life. Do you want to be somebody else? Are you sick of feeling so left out? Are you desperate to find something more before your life is over? Are you stuck inside a world you hate? Are you sick of everyone around with the big fake smiles and stupid lies while deep inside you're bleeding? No, you don't know what it's like when nothing feels alright. You don't know what it's like to be like me, to be hurt, to feel lost, to be left out in the dark, to be kicked when you're down, feel like you've been pushed around, to be on the edge of breaking down when no one's there to save you. No, you don't know what it's like. Welcome to my life. No one ever lies straight to your face, and no one ever stabs you in the back. You might think that I'm happy, but I'm not gonna be okay. Everybody always gave you what you wanted. You never had to work, it was always there. You don't know what it's like, what it's like to be hurt, to feel lost, to be left out in the dark, to be kicked when you're down, feel like you've been pushed around, to be on the edge of breaking down when no one's there to save you. No, you don't know what it's like, what it's like to be hurt, to feel lost, to be left out in the dark, to be kicked when you're down, feel like you've been pushed around, to be on the edge of breaking down when no one's there to save you. No, you don't know what it's like. Welcome to my life. Welcome to my life. Welcome to my life.
Connor, thank you. That was great. Thank you very much. Now, this is our last and final performance, and it is by our another rock band. This is the older students. So they'd like to come forward. And they're going to be performing two selections, two songs. The first is Pompeii by Bastille, and the second is Dear Maria, Count Me In by All Time Low. And on the back, the members are Joey Forkin on drums, Evan Ramos on bass, Sebastian Westfall on drums, Connor Wiz on guitar and voice, and Owen Adamo on keyboard. So this is closing up with a rock performance. And I did promise you I'd show you my last instrument. While they're, this is kind of the most shameful of them all, really. If you lack any sort of musical talent, I will be assigned this item, which is basically two spoons stuck together. And it's called playing the spoons. And traditionally, you were given two spoons, and then you would sit again, usually far away in the corner, and you basically would hit it off your leg. But you will know where you stand in the pecking order of Irish music if you're handed spoons. Just let that be a clear statement.
As we wrap up this evening, just a word of thanks, and we will thank him at the end, but it really is amazing to me the variety of instruments and songs and styles that Mr. Ju works into the program and works with daily with our children. They really do enjoy his music classes as well. They really enjoy the experience. They learn a lot, and I know that they always find him to be a warm and friendly teacher. So in addition to all this, he also teaches, right? He teaches in the classroom, and we're very grateful to have him. And so the first song that they will perform is Pompeii by Bastille.
If you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How I'm gonna be an optimist about this? How I'm gonna be an optimist about this? But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How I'm gonna be an optimist about this? How I'm gonna be an optimist about this? But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How I'm gonna be an optimist about this? How I'm gonna be an optimist about this? If you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
For the last song, we welcome Sebastian to the drums, and we thank Joey for the first song. And we have Dear Maria, Count Me In by All Time Low.
ready. I got your picture, I'm coming with you, dear Maria, count me in. There's a story at the bottom of this bottle, and I'm the pen. When the lights go out, I wanna watch the way you take the stage by storm. The way you wrap those boys around your finger. Go on and play the leader, cause you know it's what you're good at. Oh, for the fast track, make every second pay, yeah, yeah. Cause I got your picture, I'm coming with you, dear Maria, can't be in. There's a story at the bottom of this bottle, and I'm the man. Make it count when I'm the one. Don't it sound so easy? Never had a doubt. Now I'm going crazy watching from the floor. Take a blessing, let the rest come easy. Never settle down, cause the castle leaves me always wanting more. I got your picture, I'm coming with you, dear Maria, count me in. There's a story at the bottom of this bottle, and I'm the pen. Make it count when I'm the one who's telling you out. But it feels like feeling hearts falling. You came from the crowd. Cause I got your picture, I'm coming with you, dear Maria, count me in. There's a story at the bottom of this bottle.
Boys, that was very good. Thank you. Excellent. That concludes our program. Just wanted to see if Mrs. Fagan wanted to have a few more words. But that does conclude the program. What better way could you spend a Wednesday night, right, in May, than listening to the great music? I do want to offer the microphone to Mrs. Fagan.
Once again, we just thank Mr. Jew and all of our wonderful musicians tonight. And we especially thank our parents for their support of this, the children's talents and gifts that God has given them. So thank you and God bless. We can just have students help introduce their afternoon and prepare for our Lord again. And then thank you and have a wonderful night and be safe.